This is George Price, and just a while back we met a very remarkable individual, Mr. Willis Craft from Greenfield, Indiana. We'd like you to meet this gentleman too. Hi Willis, how are you?
Hi George, I'm fine.
Well, you just finished a beautiful job here in Pendleton.
Well, thank you very much.
Okay, it's a great addition to the property here. It's a wood fence. Is it redwood?
It's western red cedar. That's 6-inch board western red cedar. That's what it is. Yeah.
Well, you say you live in Greenfield. How long have you lived there, sir?
About 23 years,
yeah,
in Greenfield.
And before that?
I lived in Hancock County, but out on Blue River, way east of Greenfield.
Okay.
It's Hancock County.
All right. So you've been in business 44 years.
44 years in April, yeah.
How'd you get started?
Sears and Roebuck.
Yeah.
They had an ad in the paper for a contractor, and I went there and tried out for 2 weeks. And I've been doing it ever since.
There you were, huh?
Yeah.
There you were.
Got into it and couldn't get out, I guess.
Well, how's things changed over the years?
Well, when we started, about all it was residential chain link fence and commercial chain link fence. And that was, there's a little bit of wrought iron. Then a few years later, then the wood came in.
Yeah.
Then after the wood, they started doing these newer homes, a lot of wrought iron. Then the vinyl come in.
Yeah.
And it's wood and vinyl now.
It's all wood and vinyl.
Yeah, huh? And wrought iron. That's
Well, in a year's time, I know you're busy because I've talked to the folks that you're doing this fence for. How many miles of fence you think you put up a year?
Oh, Lord. Well, we used to have to get permits when we worked for Sears, and I kept track of it for 1 year. And we put in 104,000 feet that year.
No kidding.
Three of us, a three-man crew, put in 104,000 feet the year that I kept track of it. So some years is more than others, and
yeah,
it's hard to tell how much fence,
yeah,
that we put in.
One thing we haven't got into yet, a lot of people who have gotten to your place in life are looking for something a little easier. How old was your last birthday?
65.
65.
Yeah.
Man, it's just amazing. It really is. Congratulations.
Well, thank you. Thank you. I like it. It's been good to me.
Yeah.
You have to work hard.
Yeah. In business for yourself, a lot of people, perhaps they do, perhaps they don't understand the sacrifices you have to make for being in business for yourself.
Well, there's a lot of things you got to give up your free time. You start out at 6 o'clock in the morning, and sometimes you're 10, 11 o'clock at night filling in for the next day, getting ready for the next day. So it's not all 8-hour shift to go home.
Yeah.
It's work when you answer your phone, do your work, do the estimates, and make your own welding gates, wrought iron gates, yeah, and stuff. Sometimes you're out in that shop for 10, 11 o'clock at night, yeah, sometime longer.
You got any jobs that stick out in your mind of all the fences you've done over the years?
None in particular. I got some rough ones.
Yeah?
In Kentucky.
Oh.
As a matter of fact, we're going back this week.
Yeah.
Back,
okay,
into Kentucky, and it's rocky and stone, and there's some good jobs and there's some bad jobs.
Yeah. Well, you said Pendleton's a little like that. You said there's a couple of rocks down here?
I got a bruised leg now from digging this job. I think this is 300 feet and ain't nothing but rock.
Yeah. Okay, well, I'll tell you what, you're just an amazing individual. And, there's a lot of young people coming out here in today's economy wanting to get started. What advice would you give them?
Well, they gotta put it, if they like their job, they gotta put it, their head to the job, and to make it go, it don't just come easy. I mean, you got to work for it. If they like it, they need to stick to it and treat it like a job.
And you said something earlier about education is real important.
They need a college education today.
To go as far as they can go.
To go as far as they can go, because today you can't hardly get a decent job unless you got an education.
Yeah.
So I would suggest education.
Okay.
Real hard.
All right. Well, you know you've been out here for several days. You're probably ready to get back home and get started for the next, aren't you?
We're headed to another wood job today.
Yeah.
We've got one on a trailer out there now. We're going to do another one today.
Oh, man, you don't stop, do you?
The wife won't let me.
All right.
No, we just go out there, work our job, and get done, we go home.
Been a pleasure, sir.
Why, it's been a pleasure, George. Glad to talk to you and glad to have met you.
Glad to meet you, too.
And hope to see you again sometime.
I think we will.
All right, buddy.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.